freedom-related issues for years now. How many years, Michael?
30.
30 years. And he's also a super great guy, and we're really, really to have you both here with us and talking about food rights and responsibilities and how they relate to us. Thank you.
Mike, why don't you take it away?
Take it all the way back to the beginning of the Constitution and really rock the crowd here.
Most of us know that Thomas Jefferson wrote the Declaration of Independence. Most people are aware that he made a really egregious mistake. And that's at the very beginning where he says, we hold these truths to be self-evident. Today we would replace self-evident with the word obvious. And unfortunately, there is no such thing as obvious. When Christopher Columbus headed west across the ocean, most people thought it was obvious that the world is flat, but they were wrong. If I ask you today, who owns your body? Most of us feel that the answer to that question is fairly obvious. You know, in 2013, most of us assume that we own our own bodies. Every man, woman, and child owns their own body, and that if someone else owns your body, then you're a slave. And all of us, I think, are, you know, would agree that slavery is immoral and improper and just totally unacceptable. However, the government controls our lives and our bodies in ways that we pretty much take for granted. If I own my body, I decide what food I eat, I decide what liquids I drink, you know, and what I'm going to do, you know, to earn a living. Well, in the early 1900s, Congress passed the 18th Amendment establishing prohibition. And once we had prohibition, everybody in the United States stopped drinking alcohol, didn't they? No. No, of course not. Are you going to tell me that good, patriotic Americans ignored the Constitution, they ignored the 18th Amendment, and they drank alcohol anyway? Well, yes, because nowhere in the Constitution does Congress have the authority to control your body, to control what you eat and what you drink. I mean, the idea that Congress can tell American adults whether or not they can have a drink is ludicrous. And within history, the 18th Amendment is the only one that's ever been repealed. The 21st Amendment came along and ended prohibition. Well, there may be some arguments against alcohol.